Yo, what's up guys, Karan Plays here and welcome back to the third episode of the Borussia Dortmund Career Mode series. In the last episode, we played two matches in the Bundesliga, won our first match comfortably and in the second match, it took a lot of hard work and perseverance. In the 85th minute, Ashraf Hakimi went ahead and scored a stunning volley against Köln and we went ahead and got the 3 points there, but that performance from him wasn't good enough to earn him a nomination in the Player of the Episode contenders. Let's go ahead and take a look at the Player of the Episode contenders and who went ahead and won it. Our first player up for contention was Erling Braut Haaland. He scored a brace against Augsburg and the next player was very instrumental in us keeping both of our clean sheets. Mats Hummels right here, but Erling Braut Haaland overwhelmingly guys went ahead and won the vote. Here he has his 83 rated Player of the Episode card. Y'all voted for him and he becomes our first Player of the Episode winner of the series. If there is one thing we learned from that match against Köln is that our team is far from perfect. I'd shortlisted three marquee players amongst which we would sign one and honestly guys, Emre Can isn't gonna cut it, which is why I thought that he wouldn't cut it, which is why when I was scouting Richarlison, I'd also started scouting Lucas Torreira, so we potentially might see a swap happen for Lucas Torreira and Emre Can. The other CDM slash central midfielder who I thought is good enough to, you know, maybe replace Emre Can was Konrad Laimer. I've sent a scout to learn more about him, but before getting into our CDM roles guys, we first gotta discuss who amongst these three are we gonna be bringing into our club to replace Jadon Sancho. And well, I went through the comment section, Kai Havertz got no nomination, so no way I'm gonna sign him. It was between Leroy Sané and Aubameyang, and Leroy Sané just about edged Aubameyang, even though Aubameyang would have been insane. But guys, we're gonna first try and sign Sané. If he's not within our budget, then probably we'll fall back to Aubameyang. But first, we've gotta go ahead and try and sign Leroy Sané. Okay, so Leroy Sané is not gonna come cheap. He's probably gonna cost us around the 70-80 million mark. I'm first gonna, you know, start off with a 60 million valuation. I know he's just valued at 52 million, but I guess 60 million is a decent place to start off with. Well, as you all can see, they want 77 million for Sané. Ain't too bad, but let's try with 67 million. I'm offering them 10 million less than what they want and an initial 7 million jump from my initial offer. Hey, you know what? This is actually insane, man. 69.9 million for Leroy Sané. I'll take it, man. No release clause or sell-on clause or anything like that. 69.9 million. Leroy Sané might just be heading to the Signal Iduna Park. He wants a crucial role at the club. That's exactly what I was looking for. Obviously, he's replacing Jadon Sancho, who was one of our regular starters, which is why a crucial role is exactly what he should be getting. A 5-year deal. Hopefully he'll accept that. Perfect, that's what he was after. Let's go ahead and now discuss his salary. Premier League has that TV money. Let's try and get him for 150,000. We've got to at least give him a big bonus, I guess, then. Let's give him an 800,000 signing bonus and 150,000 per week. Hopefully he'll accept that. Perfect, guys. That's a fair offer. Leroy Sané is heading to the Signal Iduna Park. And guys, this is a pretty sweet deal. Well, I guess we no longer need Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang on our shortlist. And you know what? Let's actually hold off on Lucas Torreira for a while before, you know, Konrad Laimer's final scouting report comes in. Let's hold off for a bit. Deadline day is here and the final scouting report of Konrad Laimer has finally come in. But honestly, looking at the base stats, Lucas Torreira looks like a much better option. So first, I'll try and sign him. If not, Konrad Laimer ain't a bad second option. Okay, so here we are negotiating with Arsenal and I'm obviously going to offer them Emre Can in a player swap deal. He's valued more than Lucas Torreira. Hopefully they want a midfielder and will agree with the straight swap deal. Oh come on man, they want 13 million plus him. That's a little excessive. Let's bring it down to 3 million I guess. I know, I don't think they'll accept it, but still man, 3 million plus Emre Can, I can live with it. But 13 million plus Emre Can, that's gonna be a ridiculous deal. Well, this is probably gonna be my last offer for Lucas Torreira. 8.5 million plus Emre Can, hopefully they'll accept it. Okay, finally man, they were being so greedy, but thankfully we've worked it out. Okay, so he wants an important role at the club, that's fine. We can rotate him obviously with Delaney and all. He'll still be playing a lot of games. I'm looking to offer him at least a 4-year deal. That's what he was after, that's perfect. And now it's time for the juicy stuff guys. The salary. We've got a 99,000 in wage budget. He's currently earning 66k. Let's give him I guess 80,000 and a signing bonus of 400k. Hopefully he'll accept that. That seems to be a decent offer to me. Hopefully he accepts that. Perfect guys, Lucas Torreira and Leroy Sané in one day just before the deadline day. I'll take that man. Well, after the transfer window has ended, this is what our side is looking like. Our game against Union Berlin, I'm looking to use my first team. Erling Braut Haaland up top, Royce and Sané on either side of him. Hakimi, Torreira, Witzel and Guerrero are midfielders. Romagnoli, Hummels and Akanji are centre-backs, and in goal, Roman Bürki. With the signings that we've made, we've also got a strong bench too, so we can compete in not only the Bundesliga but in the rest of the competitions too. Let's go ahead and get on with this game first. Back-to-back away games in the Bundesliga for us. Union Berlin versus Borussia Dortmund. I'm very excited for this one. We've made the changes necessary for our side. And well, now until the January transfer window, this is what we have. Let's go ahead and test them out now. Torreira with his first involvement in the game now. Finds Leroy Sané. Sané plays it towards Erling Braut Haaland. Now Hakimi on the ball. Hakimi looking for Leroy Sané again. That's a brilliant attack from our side. Sané taking the shot and it saved his first chance back in the Bundesliga. Goes begging. Okay, looks like Union Berlin might cause us some problems here. Bürki with a brilliant charge, man. Quick on his feet. Gets the ball off of the attacker's legs and makes a brilliant save. Sané again on the ball now. Oh, beautifully played in towards Ashraf Hakimi. Hakimi now looking for the cutback. Just takes one too many touches and well, drives the ball out of play. Haaland finding Leroy Sané again here. Leroy Sané looking for Lucas Torreira, who takes a long shot here. Wow, man, he did test the goalkeeper there. Unfortunately, couldn't find the back of the net and we get a corner now. Torreira gets the ball on the edge of the box now. Lucas Torreira finds Axel Witzel. That was great balance from him. Torreira again finding Royce now. Royce has a chance to make it 1-0. Their keeper is absolutely on fire, man. He saved 3 or 4 chances now. And well, we get another corner here. Witzel on the ball. Finds Haaland. Haaland looking for Sané. Sané's weak foot has let him down yet again, man. Should have taken it with his left foot. He misses another chance. Oh, wow. Union Berlin have a great chance here now. What a fantastic save from Bürki on the rebound though. I don't know why wasn't I controlling Romagnoli. The player wasn't switching. Witzel wasn't in a position to clear the ball and well, Romagnoli got beaten by Prommel. They make it 1-0 in the very last minutes of this first half. Awful defending from our side, man. Great save initially from Bürki here. And I was trying to switch it to Romagnoli. I don't know why it didn't happen. Prommel with practically a free header. AI defending didn't work for us and Romagnoli was caught ball watching. Second half begins. We absolutely dominated the first half, but unfortunately for us, against the run of play, Union Berlin went ahead and got the lead. We've got 45 minutes to turn things around. Hakimi on the ball now. Beautiful turn from Lucas Torreira, looking for Erling Braut Haaland, finds Royce instead, and he makes it 1-1. What a fantastic goal, man. How was Royce onside? Some fantastic work from Lucas Torreira on his debut there. Brilliant shoulder drop and well, looking for Haaland, but he finds Royce instead, who makes it 1-1. Some brilliant positioning from Royce there, a brilliant pass from Torreira, and we make it 1-1 right from our first chance in the second half. Sané looking to do something on his debut here. Up against lanes there, brilliant work from Sané. Finds Erling Braut Haaland, who can make it 2-1 for us. Another fantastic save from their keeper. And we get yet another corner. That was some brilliant running in from Leroy Sané. Keeping the ball under a lot of pressure there, winning the ball back too. And then laying it off for Erling Braut Haaland. Unfortunately, he couldn't find the top corner. Royce on set piece duty here, looking for Axel Witzel. The ball is in the crossbar and we miss another chance here. Haaland on the ball now. Finds Royce. Royce waiting for Haaland's run. Oh, that's beautiful play between these two. Again, Marco Royce on the ball. Laying it off for Erling Braut Haaland. No, he finds Leroy Sané instead. Another miss, man. Haaland on the rebound. Couldn't get it in. Leroy Sané now hits the crossbar and it is offside. I can't believe this, man. Why aren't the passes going to the player that I'm intending it for, man? Haaland has been dropped off 2 goals here. Well, guys, 69 minutes played and Sané is just cursed, I guess. He's hit the bar I don't know how many times. I'm bringing Richarlison on for him. Okay, Union Berlin might have a chance now. They've made their way into our box. Roman Bürki with a fantastic save here. Akanji, brilliant defending from him. On the rebound, he did not allow them to have a free shot. Kept pressure and we get a goal kick. 80 minutes played, it's still 1-1. We do need some more attacking output, so I'm bringing Thorgan Hazard for Guerrero now. Lucas Torreira gets the ball now. Finding Erling Braut Haaland, finally. Haaland has a chance now. He can take this on to the near post. Another brilliant save from the goalkeeper. Probably should have cut it back in hindsight. But well, another big chance goes begging. Diallo on the ball now. Looks like Union Berlin are going to have the last chance of this game. We concede in the 94th minute. Union Berlin make it 2-1. brilliant counter attack from them, man. They did what we should be doing here, taking their chances, man. With probably their second or third chance of this game, they've made it 2-1. Clinical finishing from them, and they make us pay here. That's it for this game, guys. We've taken our first L. Unfortunately, it's come so early in this season. Our finishing today was a letdown. We created an abundance of chances, but we just couldn't finish them. Unfortunately, we've dropped 3 points here, and that could be crucial in the title race. The transfer window has finally come to an end, and some clubs have done some decent business. Bayern Munich picking up Marcus Rashford for just 59.4 million. That's some outrageous business for them, man. That's absolutely insane. Liverpool picking up Jordan Henderson, Dele Alli going to Valencia, Vardy going to Manchester City, and Anthony Martial going to Atletico Madrid. Who did Manchester United end up picking up then? Looks like nobody, I guess. Well, those were the big transfers of this window. It's time we put the focus back on our squad. Before heading into our second and final game of this episode, we have gone ahead and shortlisted the final two objectives that we have to accomplish this season. First up, we've got the golden boy. Get 10 plus goal contributions with Reyna. That sums up the question that I'd asked, should we keep Reyna or not? And well, if this is gonna be one of our season objectives, he obviously has to stay. Our last objective, probably one of the toughest ones right here, avoid losing in derbies. So that means we can't lose in the Der Klassiker, we can't lose in the Revier Derby. Bayern Munich and Schalke, potentially two of our most toughest opponents, we can't lose to them. And I'm gonna keep it just in the league because, well, in the Super Cup, we already went ahead and lost against Bayern Munich. So keeping it in the league makes more sense. That's it for the objectives, guys. Let's now go ahead and find out our next opponent in the Bundesliga. Well, this ain't gonna be easy at all. We're facing Bayer Leverkusen. It's at home though, that's the only advantage that we have. Let's go ahead and take a look at the team that we're gonna be fielding against them. For this game against Bayer Leverkusen, I've switched things up a bit. I want Leroy Sané to play a little bit more out wide, which is why I've changed the formation to a 3-4-3 here. Marco Reus will be playing in his preferred cam position, Erling Braut Haaland up top. Thorgan Hazard finally making another start for the side, Schulz replacing Guerrero too. Hakimi playing in that right mid role yet again, Thomas Delaney coming in for Axel Witsel, and our back three remains the same. Mats Hummels, Roman Yuri and Akanji, and in goal, Roman Bürki. A pretty attacking side in my opinion. Hopefully though, that means we can make a lot more chances and end up scoring a lot more goals too. Let's go ahead and find out. Finally, a long awaited return at the Signal Iduna Park has come. Our fourth match in the Bundesliga, our second home game. Hopefully we can get the 3 points here. In front of the yellow wall, there is no chance that we falter. Let's go ahead and take a look at the Bayer Leverkusen starting 11. They're going with the 4-3-2-1 here and, well, have made a lot of new signings, especially in attack. Ilicic and Morales have come into the club. Kevin Volland remains up top. Bellarabi, Havertz, Arangiz and Leon Bailey, their midfielders. Their defenders are Baumgartlinger, Tapsoba and Dragovic, and in goal, Radecki. They've got a more than decent attack in midfield. Their defense, not the best, so we can possibly outscore them. But Bayer Leverkusen are never going to be an easy opponent. Let's go ahead and give it our best shot. Haaland keeping possession here. Finds Marco Reus. Thomas Delaney on the ball now, looking back for Erling Braut Haaland. Haaland can turn his defender here, takes the shot on, and unfortunately, yet again, man, misses the target by inches. Reus. Oh, that's a beautiful ball played in towards Leroy Sané. What can he do here? Still Sané on the ball. He has a deadly left foot. Oh my god. That would have been a world-class goal. Just about, yet again, by a few inches, we've missed the target. And well, the new formation also doesn't seem bad at all. Okay, we've been caught out here. Akanji is way out of position. Bellarabi finds Voland. Voland plays it to Morales. Roman Bürki comes up with yet another big save. Another dangerous chance for Bayer Leverkusen, thwarted by Roman Bürki. Volland on the ball, plays it to Havertz. Havertz back to Kevin Volland yet again, man. Roman Bürki is quick on his feet, makes another huge save for us. Reus on the ball now, looking for Haaland's run. That's a beautiful through ball. Marco Reus finding Erling Braut Haaland. Haaland 1v1 against the goalkeeper. Their defender has made a brilliant recovery challenge, and Haaland yet again falls short in front of goal. Well, that's it for the first half. We've created a lot of chances, and well, we've missed a lot of chances too. We've got to make a few changes, otherwise we're going to end up dropping more points. I've changed the formation yet again, guys. 4-3-3 attack, and I've made one substitution. I've brought Akanji off for Dahoud. This is probably our fourth formation in 3 episodes. I'm going with the 4-3-3 attack because, well, Royce in that cam role, guys, he's just different gravy. Hopefully, he can provide a lot more chances, and Haaland, Sané or Thorgan Hazard, somebody needs to step up and get the goal here. Dahoud makes an interception here, finds Haaland. Haaland releases Thorgan Hazard here. Again, some brilliant piece of defending from their side, but the ball still falls to Erling Braut Haaland. Haaland looking for Dahoud. Dahoud finds Thorgan Hazard. Thorgan Hazard with the finish shot. Finally, a chance that has hit the target, and well, Radecki makes the save. 78 minutes played, guys, and I'm making a change now, and it's gonna be a weird one. I'm bringing Haaland off for Julian Brandt, and I'm playing Royce in that striker role. Okay, we might have one last chance in this half or not, guys. Disappointing again. 0-0 against Bayer Leverkusen at home. We keep a clean sheet. That's the only positive we can take out of this match. Another 2 points dropped. Back-to-back matches, and well, back-to-back points dropped from our side. Not good at all. We're gonna struggle in the Bundesliga if these kind of performances continue. Pretty sure we've fallen far behind Bayern Munich and the other league leaders. Guys, before looking at the table and well ending the episode, we've first gotta talk about the squad. Let me know down in the comment section below what formation should I be playing. I'm looking to play Royce in a more central role, but even in that left forward role, he's been impressive. Haaland, well, his finishing has been let down. I don't know why, but yeah, he hasn't been up to the mark. So I'm open to suggestions. Let me know down in the comment section below what formation, what lineup should we be playing week in, week out. Moving on to our player of the episode section. We did drop a disaster class in both the matches, but I guess two players still had a decent output. Lucas Torreira and, well, Roman Bürki. They were the bright and shining lights in, well, what were some dull performances. Hit the like button in front of the player's name who you thought was your player of the episode. Lucas Torreira or Roman Bürki. Hit that like button right now. Well, it's already a 5-point gap between us and Bayern Munich. We are in the 6th position, and well, we haven't had the best of the starts, have we? That's it for today's episode, guys. If you all enjoy this one, smash that like button. Do not forget to share and subscribe, and obviously, always leave your suggestions and feedback down in the comment section below. Hit that bell icon if you haven't already so that you all know whenever I upload the next episode.